Hello students, today we will revise chapter 2, January Night, written by Premchand. So before we revise the chapter, let us know something about the author. Who is the author of the lesson January Night? Premchand. Okay? So Premchand is one of the greatest figure of 20th century Hindi literature. He wrote over 300 short stories, which contains a rich varieties of descriptions of Indian life. So how many short stories he has written? Around 300 short stories, and which is mostly containing about the rich variety of a description of Indian life. Okay? In many of his stories, he deals with the cruelty and pride of the privileged classes. So what is in his writings? He is mentioning more about the stories. He deals with the cruelty and pride of the privileged classes. And he shows great sympathy for the poor peasants. Peasants means the poor farmers. So when we come across the writer, who is the writer? Premchand. And he is one of the greatest figure in the 20th century in Hindi literature. And also he wrote around 300 short stories. And mainly he is deals with the cruelty and the proud of the privileged classes, and he shows the sympathy for the poor farmers. He has a great concern for the poor people, and he shows a lot of sympathy to the towards the peasants, that's the poor farmers. Okay, so this is the all about the author. So now we will just see the difficult words. You can also take on page number 31. Words to know. Okay? Calamity. Meaning of calamity is deep distress or a disaster. Calamity means deep distress or disaster. The next word is coax. C-O-A-X. Meaning is pursued. Okay, the next word, immense, I-double-M-E-N-S-E. Immense means huge, or in other words we can say great. Okay, intolerable. Intolerable means unbearable. Or next word is resentment. Resentment means feeling hurt, angry. Okay. Tenant. You will come across tenant, word tenant in this particular chapter. What is the meaning of tenant? Tenant means one who occupies land under a landlord. That is the tenant means. Okay, these are the difficult words, and you will be learning the word meanings and the word. Okay, so that you will be writing the exam well. And to explain this chapter is a little lengthy. To explain one by one, it takes a lot of time. And already we have given the explanation of each line by line we have explained. Okay? So now I will give you the short summary of the lesson, particular lesson. Okay? So that you can recall what you have learned in the previous class. And memorize and understand the lesson. And you can write the question answer by your own words also. Okay, so in this particular lesson, mainly we see the character Halku. Okay, so Halku is the main character here. We see so many places we see the name of Halku. He is a poor farmer. Okay, and the next one is Munni. Munni is the wife of Halku. And the next the character is Zebra. Who is Zebra? Do you remember who is Zebra? Zebra is the pet animal of Halku. Zebra is always with him. He whenever he goes to the field and he stays, zebra stays with him and guarding his field. Okay, and the next the character is landlord. We see him in the first part, the landlord. So what are the characters we see in the chapter? What are the characters we see here? The January night, the first one is Halku, second is Munni, and third is Zebra, the pet dog, and the fourth character is the landlord. Okay, these are the characters we see when we go through this particular chapter, January night. And this the main character is, who is the main character? Halku is the main character. Okay, children. So now let us. I will give you the summary of the short summary of this particular chapter. Halku, the farmer, demands money from his wife Munni to pay it to the landlord. We see in the first paragraph. Halku, the poor farmer, is coming towards his wife and asking her to give some money to pay to the landlord. Okay, Munni tells him that he has to buy a blanket to pass the cold night of January. So what is the wife tells the Halku? She is not giving the money all of a sudden. Okay, Halku comes and asks Munni the money, to give me some money to give the landlord, but she hesitates to give the money. And what she tells, I am not going to give right now the money, because I kept the money. For what she kept the money? She wanted to keep, buy the blanket to pass the cold night of January. So she kept that money to buy the blanket to pass the cold night of January. You know that January is the coldest cold month. Okay. So we needed to use the blankets. So she kept for that to buy a blanket. So he advises him to tell the landlord that he would pay the money after the harvest. So what the wife tells his her husband? She told that tell the landlord that he would pay him the money after the harvest, when they get the, after the harvest, when we get the money, we can give the, we can give the, pay the money. Okay. Halku tells her that if he did so, the landlord will beat, insult him, so she gives him the money. But Halku was going on asking. Finally, the wife Munni had to give the money. So Halku, she gives the money to Halku to give to the landlord. The next part we see in the chapter, Halku goes to guard his harvest in the field at January night. He is going every night to guarding the field in this January, the very cold night. The cold is so biting that he fails to guard his field. The cold was too cold. It was so biting cold that he could not guard the field. You can remember that without a blanket, without nothing to cover, how he manages in that cold weather, sleeping outside in the field. You can imagine how horrible it will be. Okay? The Nilgais graze his harvest and devastate his field. So what happened tonight? He was unable to sleep, and all of a sudden he slept off in spite of the biting cold. And then what happened? The Nilgais comes and destroys, devastate his field. Okay? Despite continuous barking of his dog Zebra, Halku prefers sleeping. But who is Zebra? You remember the pet dog of Halku. The dog also goes whenever he goes to the field, and he is a great helper to him, and he watch over the field. So, in spite of barking, continuous barking of his dog Zebra, Halku prefers sleeping. He was so tired, he can say. Next morning, what happened? The next morning, we see he is rebuked and taunted by his wife Munni. The Munni, his wife, was so angry and so irritated. But why she was so irritated and angry? Because the whole field was devastated and destroyed by the Nilgais. So now they are not going to get any profit out of that field, you know, harvest. Out of that harvest, they are not going to get anything. So wife was so angry and she rebuked and taunted. Okay? Munni for being so careless in performing his duty. So she told that you are very careless and you are not performing your duty well. So Munni for being, she got so irritated and telling so many things to Munni, and she told that you are very careless in performing the duty. That is the end of the chapter. So I just gave you a short summary of the particular lesson, that is January 9th. I hope you are remembering the story. Okay? So when you remember the story, you can automatically write the question answer by your own. Okay, children? And there are so many question answers, a reference to the context and rest of the exercises which is given in the textbook. You will be learning that also and prepare for the periodical text. Okay, students? Thank you.